Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of Andy Warhol-style pop art portraits from photos. This is an update of pop art tutorials I've done on earlier versions of Photoshop. This tutorial is in two parts. In part one, we'll create the basic template, and in part two, we'll finish it by adding colorful loose brush strokes, a brushed border, and text. Open a photo of someone that you'd like to use for this project. If you'd like to use this photo of Elvis, I provided its link in this video's description or project files. If you're using a different photo, make sure its resolution is 150 pixels per inch to ensure that the filters we'll be using will have similar results as mine. If you want to bring out the details in the shadows or dark areas of your subject, open your Dodge tool and make sure your foreground color is white. Choose midtones. Open your brush picker. We'll take care of the size in a moment. Make its hardness 0% and the exposure 100%. Then press Enter or Return. To adjust the Dodge tool's brush size, first make sure your caps lock key is not on, and then press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Then brush over the dark areas of your subject. Next, we'll remove the background from your subject by making a selection around your subject. There are many ways to do this, but since this background is a solid color, I'll use the magic wand tool. If you're using this tool as well, make its tolerance approximately 32 and make sure contiguous is checked. I'll click the background to make a selection of it, and to add other areas of the background, I'll press and hold Shift as I click on those areas. To delete areas in the face, press and hold Alt or Option as you click on those areas. If you created your selection by clicking the background, as in this example, you'll need to invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. Make a new layer below the active layer by Alt-clicking or Option-clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with white. And since white is your foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. We'll make your visible image into a smart object so we can adjust the filters that we'll be adding to it at any time. To do this, Shift-click the top layer to make both layers active, and click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel. Click Convert to Smart Object. Make two copies of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Name the top layer Glowing Edges, the middle layer Dot Halftone, and the bottom layer Cutout. Hide the top two layers. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Artistic folder and click Cutout. Make the number of levels 2, the Edge Simplicity 4, and the Edge Fidelity 2. Then click OK. Uncheck Contiguous to ensure that your magic wand tool will select all the areas in your image that match the tonal range that we'll be clicking on. Click the area of the face that represents the skin. This makes a selection of it. Press Q on your keyboard to see the selection as a quick mask. Notice your foreground and background colors automatically inverted. Black is now your foreground color. We're going to brush in a quick mask over areas outside the face. Open your pencil tool and pencil picker. If you want to adjust the brush size, use your bracket keys as you did earlier. The hardness and opacity are both 100%. Then press Enter or Return. Brush over areas outside the skin, and in this case the ear as well, to isolate those areas. Make sure there are no gaps. To fill in the area outside the face, open your Paint Bucket tool and click anywhere outside the face. If your entire image filled in, it means that there's a gap in your brush lines and you need to close it. Click once more to ensure that the edges are completely filled in. Press Q to make the quick mask into a selection and go to Select and Save Selection. Name it Inside Face and click OK or press Enter or Return. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. In the Input Highlight field, type in 183 to brighten it. Make the dot halftone layer visible and active. Invert your foreground and background colors by either pressing X on your keyboard or by clicking this icon. Go back to Filter and Filter Gallery. Close the Artistic folder and open the Sketch folder. Click Halftone Pattern. The pattern type is dot, the size is 1, and the contrast is 22. Change the blend mode to darken and reduce its opacity to 70%. Open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control-click or Command-click the thumbnail of the Inside Face channel to make a selection of it. Open back your Layers panel and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the dot halftone. Make the Glowing Edges layer visible and active. Go back to Filter and Filter Gallery. Close the Sketch folder and open the Stylize folder. Click Glowing Edges. The edge width is 1, the edge brightness is 20, and the smoothness is 15. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. We want to restrict the adjustment layer to affect only the Glowing Edges layer and not all the layers in the Layers panel. To do this, we need to clip the adjustment layer to the Glowing Edges layer. Click the Clipping Mask icon or press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. In the Input Shadow field, type in 37, and in the Input Highlight field, type in 242. Make the Glowing Edges layer active and change its blend mode to Exclusion. Click the top layer to make it active and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Levels again, but this time we won't clip it because we want it to affect all the layers below it in the Layers panel. In the Input Highlight field, type in 193. In part 2, we'll complete our Warhol pop art portrait by adding colorful loose brush strokes, a brush border, and text. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.